Similar ideas, let's try to create that whole cutout on this face here. So again, if I just tried to sketch here, of course it's not going to allow me because it's not on a planar or a flat face. So I have to create a flat face to work on. So again, I'll go to Add, Construction Plane, and let's check what types I have available. So parallel to a face is kind of what I'm looking for. So in this case, parallel to face at a specific point. So first it's going to ask me to select my face, so it will be this cylindrical face here, and then tap next, and then select a point. So notice I tap any point here, and it's going to create a nice flat face parallel to my cylindrical face. So I can kind of tap and drag this to move it wherever I'd like, and it should snap to the areas I'd like as well. So in this case, I'm going to try to snap right onto this existing line on that edge, so I know that that is dead on this edge here. So it should be exactly in the middle of my cylindrical face as well. And happy with that, tap the done check. And then I can double tap to make sure I'm normal to that plane. And just sketching this plane again, it was just a simple circular cutout. And I'll throw something here, maybe lock that in. And throw in a value for the radius as well. And now I have a nice circular sketch here that I can use to extrude or cut away material as I need on this cylindrical face. So in this case, I wanted to maybe drill or cut a hole through the cylindrical face. Otherwise, may have been impossible. But in this case, I can just make my component through this body here. Notice here, by default, it's actually not removing material. But we'll see that I can use my subtract tool later on to essentially subtract this body from my original body to create that whole cutout. Finally, my slot cutout on the top of my cylindrical face works in a very similar manner. So I'm going to add, construction plane, check what types I have available. And this time I'm going to try perpendicular to a curve at a point. So first I'm going to select my curve, maybe this cylindrical curve here. And notice now it is creating a plane perpendicular to that curve. And again, I can move my control point wherever I'd like here. In this case, I want to throw it somewhere about here, or exactly on kind of the top of my plane there. I'm happy with that. Tap done. And again, you can double tap on my plane and create whatever sketch I'd like. You'll notice that I have all four of my planes visible here. But if I'd like, I can show and hide these as well however I'd like. So I can go into my groups, construction planes, and I can show or hide these however I'd like to make it a little bit easier to read. So this was the plane I've just created there, and I'm going to create a bit of a slot cutout, let's say something like this. And then maybe move it however far I'd like within my object. Just see how much I'd like to cut away from my slot cutout. Notice what can be useful here as well is maybe change my appearance option to also show my hidden edges. So that will make my body somewhat transparent, and I can see my internal or hidden edges. So I'll just jump back to that view here, and now I can see these edges through my body. So again, that was just within appearance and turning on or off show hidden edges. So you can see you just have the ability to see those edges behind a solid body. And if I'm happy with that, again, will be a similar idea. Well, I want to extrude, and then maybe use our subtract tools later on to make this a cut. In the next lesson, we'll learn about construction axes, which work in a fairly similar manner to our construction planes.